And I want to ask you really quickly before we move on, how unusual is it for the CDC to differ this much from the FDA in its recommendation?
Yeah, there were certainly past cases where the CDC would differ from the FDA, and actually it would sometimes cause chagrin within the FDA when CDC would narrow the recommendations being made by FDA. And this happens sometimes in the context of vaccines as well. I can't remember a precedent where the CDC's advisory panel differed this starkly from the FDA's recommendation, however. I think that this is far more explicit than what I remember in the past. Usually in the past, it was on the margins of the FDA's decisions, where CDC would sometimes have disagreements. This is a very explicit deviation from the FDA's recommendation. I mean, the FDA very clearly, the advisory panel, wanted to scope in people 18 and above who are at risk from severe COVID because of occupational exposure, which would include all the healthcare providers in the nation. I think that was one of the reasons why FDA ultimately came down where they did, because they felt that the healthcare providers, many of whom were vaccinated last December and January, should be eligible for boosters. Under the CDC's recommendation, if it is in fact put into effect, a healthcare provider wouldn't be eligible for a booster unless they have an underlying medical condition and qualify because of their underlying health condition. Notwithstanding the fact that a lot of healthcare providers that I'm aware of are already getting boosters, I think a lot of healthcare providers will continue to do that. Under this guidance, they wouldn't be eligible unless they have a medical problem.